Hi friends, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. With the help of Oma from Radiant Images, today we are going to do a low-light VR camera comparison. The VR cameras in this test are Zcam K1 Pro, 2X Panasonic GH5, and the Kandao Obsidian S. We call this comparison the candle test, which we are going to light the room with only candles. And we measure the noise and performance and find out which one is best for extreme low-light scenario. This is a VR180 video. To see 3D stereo and look around, you need to watch this on a VR headset. And here is the instruction on how. The first test is from the Zcam K1 Pro, shooting at ISO 1600. Please note, in a real production, especially VR180 production, you will never light a set only with candlelight. But even in this extreme situation, we can still see me and my face pretty well in this candlelight environment. In such a high ISO, you see moving digital noise from the Zcam K1 Pro. Even with the Micro Four Thirds sensor, noise is unavoidable from the Zcam, so don't buy into the misconception that Zcam K1 Pro or the V1 Pro will magically look good in the extreme low light environment. And here is the same Zcam K1 Pro footage, but with the Neat Video Denoiser Adobe Premiere plugin. As you can see, it is possible to get rid of the moving noise in post-production. If you can resharpen the footage with the Boris Effect Continuum VR units, even this footage can be rescued in post. But expect a decent amount of post-processing in any low-light production with the K1 Pro. The next test is from the Kandao Obsidian S, shooting at ISO 1600 and in 6K 30fps. The footage is not as sharp as the K1 Pro, but the Obsidian has way less noise than the K1 Pro. The low-light footage is very clean without the use of any denoiser plugin. I am very surprised by the quality of this VR360 camera. With a smaller sensor than the K1 Pro or the V1 Pro. Yes, the quality of the K1 Pro is still better and letting more light into the sensor, so slightly brighter image. But without the need of heavy post-production touch-up, Kandao Obsidian has its very special place in low-light production. This is shot before the Kandao recent announcement of further improvement of low-light performance. So hopefully, the new update from Kandao will fix some coloring issue in low light and further reduce the digital noise. The last test is from Panasonic LUMIX GH5. I thought the image quality will be the best from the GH5 in vlog and 10-bit. But surprise me, the image quality of the GH5 is actually very bad in low light. The coloring noise and the banding in vlog from the GH5 make the footage unusable. Also, it does not seem that the GH5 Micro Four Thirds sensor letting as much light compared to the Zcam K1 Pro. I'm very disappointed in the performance of the GH5. I hope the GH5S will have better performance in low light scenario. But since the GH5S has a non-square sensor with a smaller vertical size, the resolution cannot go up to 6K in 30fps. We might look into Sony Alpha 7 Mark II for further testing. So all the original test footage for all three cameras are available to download for free, so find a download link in the description below. If you like the test, don't forget to give me a thumb up and let me know what you want me and Radiant Images to test next. Don't forget to subscribe if you want more professional VR180 and VR260 tutorials and camera reviews. Hey guys, thank you for watching. With me here, we have Omar from Radiant Images.
Hey guys, here at Radiant Images, we can help you out with camera rentals. If you guys are interested in 2D, 3D, or VR camera packages, we can do that for you. Please call in today, schedule a demo, or book a rental. Thanks.
And we'll see you again next time.